And welcome into another live broadcast here at Revolution Ice Gardens. I'm alongside JD Fogarty, and we have a special game for you guys today. It is the senior day for four players on the Temple Ice Hockey team. So we have Hayden Richards, Jay Swartz, Matt Kulikowski, and of course Brett Weichner all getting celebrated today before the game. Welcome, JD. How's it going?
It's going great. Great to be here. Should be a good game out here today for the Temple Owls.
And now, JD, this is another game against the Westchester Golden Rams. The Owls have not fared too hot against them so far this season. They're going to look at turning around, and especially coming after last week's game against Drexel where they lost 6-1. The seniors are going to have to show up today and give one last go for their Temple team here.
Absolutely. It's going to be a hard-fought game. Earlier in the season, Temple played this Westchester team in the finals of the Big Five tournament, and they lost that game. It was a close game, though. It was a well-fought game. Westchester's another team that hasn't been really having a successful season so far this year, so hopefully we'll see some good hockey out here, good competition between two pretty evenly matched teams, in my opinion.
Well, JD, it seems that every time that Temple plays Westchester, Westchester just outplays them. But they're going to look at turning around today, and this is a team the seniors going to have something to prove coming in their senior day. Of course, it is not the last home game of the season. The last home game is Friday. That's a 10 o'clock start, so they wanted to make senior day on this Sunday.
Absolutely. Don't blame them.
So in goal, senior Hayden Richards is going to be the netminder. And then, of course, the other three seniors are starting. And then Giazza and Pierce are the other two forwards. So we have Swartz and Krulikowski on D, and then Weichner on offense.
Good starting lineup for the Owls. You see Giazza, who's been young player, who's been playing a lot of quality minutes for the Owls along with the senior guys. Looks like Coach Pacetti's trying to mix things up a little bit with his lines, you know, shake some life in the team. Also get the seniors some starting time, so hopefully the Owls will be able to come out strong with that starting lineup and play some good hockey.
Now, JD, last week against Drexel, we saw a pretty ugly game. They had 69 shots against. Ben Auerbach got 63 saves and couldn't get the win. They're not going to be able to do that against Hayden Richards. He's not as strong as a goalie as Auerbach is. He's a good goalie, but if they get 69 shots against, Hayden Richards is going to get chased early in his senior game.
Absolutely. I think the name of the game for the Owls in this game, as it has been in most games, is defense has got to step up. The offense has to step up too, obviously. You can't win a game if you don't score any goals, but the defense has to step up and try to stop scoring opportunities from happening against their goalies. And I think that all starts with the name we've been talking about all season. Sorry, I got a little quiet there. Name we've been talking about all season being Ryan Dumbach. I think his play's definitely got to set the tone for the Owls. He's a defenseman, but he's, you know, a scoring defenseman mostly. He leads the team in assists and points. And I think if, you know, Temple's going to be able to have a strong showing on defense, score goals, and stop Westchester from shooting so many shots, like what happened last week, I think we're going to have to see Dumbach be successful in this game early on.
And JD, one thing that they have to do is they have to keep the offensive pressure up. We say it a lot this season, especially the last game, but every time they got a shot on net, it would just be followed by the other team getting it out of the zone. So they have to keep up the offensive pressure if they want to score goals.
Absolutely. I think, you know, defense is important, but offense is also very important. Temple didn't really get a lot of scoring chances in last week's game, due in small part to how much pressure they were facing from a very solid Drexel team. But when you got a more evenly matched team against you here like they have in Westchester, you know, name of the game I still believe is defense, but you got to get scoring opportunities. You got to start early, got to put pucks on the net, create the pressure on the goalie, and that's how you're going to get them to crumble and win this game.
All right, well, the warm-ups are over. They're going to cut the ice, and then we're going to start our pregame senior celebration. So we'll be back very shortly for that, and keep it locked in. And welcome back in. We're about to start the Senior Day presentation. Please listen in.
We would now like to take some time to thank all our seniors for their hard work and dedication towards the Temple Hockey Club. First up, number one, Aiden Richards. Aiden is a finance major and has played 2 years for Temple. His favorite hockey memory is winning a national championship with the Ice Dogs, and after graduating, Aiden plans on working at Prudential. Next up, number 63, Heck Whitner. Brett is a kinesiology major who has played 2 years here at Temple. His favorite hockey memory is scoring his first hat trick against TCNJ. After graduating, Brett plans on attending grad school for physical therapy. Next up, number 17, Jay Swartz. Jay is a risk management and insurance major and has played 3 years for Temple. His favorite hockey memory is watching Brett Wisner score his first hat trick against TCNJ. After graduating, Jay plans on working at Law Ranches. Finally, number 22, Matt Gulikowski. Matt is an advertising major who has played all 4 years at Temple. His favorite hockey memory is also watching Brett Wisner score his hat trick against TCNJ. After graduating, Matt plans on coaching at Snyder Hockey before starting his career in advertising. Once again, we'd like to congratulate all our seniors for this year and thank them for their service to the team.
A great Senior Day presentation.
In goal, number one, Mike Rick.
And the presentation of the starting lineups here for both teams.
At left defense,
and again, for the Owls, it's Richards in net, Kulikowski and Swartz on defense, and then Wojcicki, Giazza, and Pierce at the forward positions. And JD, there's going to be a lot for these seniors to prove on this Senior Day. You think they're going to be able to get something going and make a lasting memory here?
I hope so. I mean, you know, when you have ceremonies like that before the game, hopefully it's able to pump up the team a little bit, get some things started. They're announcing the starting lineups now for both teams. And, you know, hopefully Temple can get something going in this game here today.
And, you know, JD, of the four seniors, three of them, their favorite memory was when Brett Wojcicki scored a hat-trick against TCNJ, so maybe he can repeat that performance and give him another favorite memory.
Yeah, hopefully put it in his mind. Maybe he'll start something up again, you know, be able to do that again against this team. That'd be great.
Jack Pierce, the center. That's surprising to me. I thought Wojcicki would have been the center. He usually takes the faceoff for the Owls, so maybe Pierce is just a better faceoff guy.
We'll see how that works out here for the Owls.
Thank you. for some hockey. Owls versus Golden Rams. Two of the not so top teams in the division. Owls actually 3 points ahead of the Golden Rams in the ECHA, so maybe they've got the advantage of this game, JD.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we'll have to see how this game works out. Temple being 2-9-0 on the season for the ECHA, while Westchester is 1-15-0, which is something that's very interesting going to this game. On paper, Temple may be the stronger team. They're pretty evenly matched. I don't want to say that one's a stronger team than the other. They're very evenly matched, so we'll have to see how Temple performs against this Westchester team that's got a couple good players. Jake Horacek stands out immediately. He's their team leader in points and goals and assists, kind of their own Ryan Dumbach, if you will, and John Mango, also a leader in goals and assists. So we'll have to see how this team shakes out against a tough Westchester opponent.
Well, you know, they say, JD, Horacek more like Skoracek. I believe they say that in some
circles.
I don't
think anybody says that.
I guarantee at least one person has ever said that in their lifetime. So, an eye to keep on number 22, Jake Horacek. And, of course, Ryan Dumbach for the Owls is the man to watch, with Auerbach sitting for senior Hayden Richards.
I mean, he's always the one we talk about. He's always the one to watch. The only other name that stands out maybe early on, Charles Giazza's getting the starting nod. He has 12 goals on the season. He's been a breath of life for these Owls, a young player, which is very crucial for the Owls going forward in the future years. Joey Powell also a name to look out for. The problem with Powell, though, is he's the leading scorer. He's also the leader in penalty minutes. We saw Powell take, I think, two or three penalties on his own last weekend against Drexel. Temple's got to avoid getting into penalty trouble. That's always been one of their Achilles heels in the past, getting too many bad penalties, getting too many unnecessary penalties that puts their team behind. Got to avoid that going into this game.
And also, JD, Matt Krulikowski, the captain, took a couple of bad penalties last game that I wouldn't say cost them the game, but definitely did not help. As we're about to get underway, puck drop goes to Westchester, but Jack Pierce is right there, gives it to Giazza, nice quick shot on net, but that is easily saved. And now Westchester will take over with the puck in their defensive zone. The Owls get it back in, however. And number one in net, Michael Rice. So it's a one versus one in net today, with Richards going against Rice.
Rice having a pretty solid season so far. Got a 4.20 goals against average, 8.887 save percentage, 7-7-1 on the season. Should be a good opponent for the Owls to play during this game.
And JD, so far so good for the Owls. They're keeping a lot of pressure in the offensive zone. And already a couple of shots for the Owls, but Rice has been able to stop them pretty easily. And that one's going to be touched, and actually it's going to be an icing right there. So less than a minute into the game, and we're going to have our first stoppage.
Now, while we're talking about the man in net for Westchester, let's move over to the man in net for Temple, Hayden Richards. He has admittedly seen a little bit less of a starting work with this season with the emergence of a hot young goaltender, Ben Auerbach, but he has been pretty good in net. His record is 1-7, which, you know, isn't great, but and his save percentage numbers, excuse me, aren't that great either, but he has also faced a high volume of shots that he's not ready for, so it'll be interesting to see how he performs in this game. He'll definitely have to be a key player if the Owls want to win this one.
Well, JD, faces a high volume of shots is something that any Temple goaltender can put on their resume. Definitely not something that you want on your resume,
yeah,
but
absolutely not.
Some handle it better than others.
You get a lot of practice for those shots.
And an easy shot right there. Great play. Joey Powell scores one-time goal. And less than a minute and a half into this game, we have a 1-0 lead for the Owls.
Beautiful play there. Great assist pass from behind the net to Powell in the front. I talked about him right before the broadcast, Patrick. He's a crucial player in this game. Temple's leading scorer with 13 goals on the season. That's his 14th goal. A beautiful shot off of a beautiful pass. Buries it into the back of the net. Temple takes the 1-0 lead.
And now the Owls will hopefully take this energy, something they really needed in the game against Drexel. So far, they've been playing exactly how they need to just a minute and a half into this game.
Absolutely, Patrick. We talked about the importance of the Owls coming out strong and energizing the team. Looks like the senior day ceremony did give them the energy they needed. They got off to an early lead, which is something, as a Temple fan, you can't say often. But it's good for Temple here to get this cushion of a one-goal lead early on in this game.
And they're definitely coming out here and skating very aggressively as Powell takes that one back over. Powell, the goal scorer. It looked like it came from Devlin and maybe even Trevs on that goal. And now Westchester trailing just 2 minutes into the game. And now Dumbach, the leading scorer for the Owls, throws it in, and Rice stops that. We'll leave it for a defender. Westchester now skating up with it, and Nucero takes the puck. He's going to go on. Looks like Betzger lost his glove there for a second. Dumbach now with it, sends it back around the corner. Westchester will get it and look to start something, but Betzger's right up there on the puck. And JD, the Owls are playing very aggressively right now, which is what you like to see.
Absolutely. A lot of big pressure plays from the Owls. Even when they're in their own offensive zone, they're playing good defense, trying to keep the scoring chances going.
And that's going to be a penalty against the Owls. Looks like Nucero is going to the box. Not sure what that penalty was. Maybe a cross check. And JD, actually, it looked like Nucero was the one on the ground in the corner, so I'm surprised that he's getting the penalty. Looks, but the Owls will be shorthanded for 2 minutes now.
Looks like they're giving him 2 minutes for slashing on that play.
And maybe JD was a little bit of a retaliation for when he went down. But the Owls shorthanded for 4 minutes, that is. So
Double minor.
Golden Rams don't even have a shot on net right now.
I'm sure that'll change in the next 4 minutes, hopefully at least.
And they're sending another player into the box for the Owls. Interesting to know why for this. If it's a double minor, then it would be Nucero has to sit in the box for all 4 minutes, but they've thrown Brendan Murray in there as well, so he's going to have some time in the box as well. And now Westchester will look to get something started on the man advantage. 4 minutes coming from them, and right away the Owls defense doing a good job getting it out of the zone. And Westchester will look to make an attack right here. In the corner, Giazza with a good defensive play right there to get in the way. They're trying to get something started. Giazza with another poke right there, and that gets it out of the zone. So far 30 seconds gone on the power play, and their Golden Rams haven't even got a shot on net. This is Bill Swall looking for something. He shoots it. That gets deflected and saved by Richards, and the Owls get it out of the zone. So 3 minutes left on the power play, and the Owls will switch up their lines.
Great clear there by, looked like, Giazza being able to get the puck out of his goalies, out of in front of his goalie, so that got a little bit less pressure on him out there.
And here comes Trevs with the puck. Trevs will throw it all the way down the ice. And it looks like it's Pierce going up after it with the Westchester defender. So still, even when they clear it, the Owls are putting some pressure on the Golden Rams.
They're staying aggressive. Even here on the penalty kill, they have been staying aggressive in this game, which is something you want to see if you're a Temple Owls fan.
And Richards comes out of the net and almost turns that one over. That could have been ugly if he couldn't get back to the net, but Seachuk was there. Devlin now with it. Devlin throws it out of the zone. And the Owls doing a good job right here as Rice stops that 2:22 left on the power play.
Going to be an offensive zone faceoff for the Owls, which is something you're not usually accustomed to seeing when a team is on the penalty kill. Maybe they can get a scoring opportunity here if they try, but I think even though with this offensive zone penalty, the main advantage for the Owls should be stopping Westchester from attacking down their ice.
And Westchester wins the faceoff, so they're going to try to get something going. And it's Smith and Powell, Dumbach and Seachuk out there for the Owls. And Dumbach gets it out of the zone immediately after it comes in. Westchester bringing it back up, though. And they'll look for something, a good pass, and that gets deflected by an Owl stick. And still looking for something. A nice save there by Richards. Just a little over halfway through this penalty kill for the Owls, and they've only allowed 2 shots on net. So far, so good for this team and this penalty kill.
Like you said, this has been a crucial penalty kill for the Owls, only allowing 2 shots on net, a little bit over halfway through the 4-minute double minor. On Nucero, this is going to be huge for the Owls going forward here. Another stoppage in play.
And that faceoff was one right back to Hayden Richards. And instead of trying to do something with it, he just fell on it.
Smart move by Hayden Richards. You know, again, another the exact same play. Go and see if Temple can clear the puck out. Kill a little bit more of this penalty like they've been able to do so effectively so far.
And Westchester wins that faceoff. And they will throw it out of their own. Wow, they called it still in the zone. An interesting call there by the lines judge. And now Westchester working with it. A great pass, but Richards would have been beat if they could have gotten a shot, but they couldn't.
Richards was flailing around there, excuse me. He was lucky that the Westchester player was not able to find that pass, or else it would be a tie game here.
Yeah, that was a wide-open net, JD, and their Golden Rams just couldn't capitalize on it, but they have another opportunity right here. Still another minute 15 left on this penalty. And Westchester looking for something. Playing with it in the corner right now. The shot, but that's wide right. Goes back around, and they send it into the corner. This is Jay Swartz playing defense right here. He gets a hold of the puck. He's going to try to get it to Smith. And Smith can't get it, but that goes out of the zone. Powell now racing up. And Powell is tripped, and that's going to be a penalty. So a great job by the Owls right there to kill that penalty. And now they're going to be 4-on-4 for 45 seconds and then have in minute 15 of their own power play.
Very smart play there we saw by Joey Powell. Not only was he able to steal the puck, but he was able to draw the penalty. Huge here for the Owls. They've done such a good job on the kill so far in this double minor, and now they're going to be able to be rewarded from it, excuse me, by getting a little bit of power play time of their own.
So very good job of this Owls defense, something that you don't really see too often with all the shots that usually go on net, but they only allowed 3 shots on that double minor for 3 minutes and 15 seconds as that shot is deflected wide left. And Wojcicki in the corner fighting for it. That'll get out to Trevs. Trevs hits it. Chiazza gets a stick on it, but that's saved by Rice. And Wojcicki trying to get it to Trevs, but that is taken away. Wojcicki now chasing it down. Good defense by Wojcicki right there. Chiazza going after the puck, but Westchester will get there before him. And that would have been an offside. So the penalty is over for the Owls. They're back on. They're now on the power play for a minute and 15 seconds. So Westchester's going to have to kill this. And now Giazza with it. He'll just send it into the zone. And it looks like that is Ploppert chasing after it. Devlin now with the puck. He sends it back around. Dumbach going after it. And that'll be tipped, go out of the zone, and that's going to be a high stick call against the Owls, so we're going to have a face-off.
It'll be interesting to see what Temple's able to do with this power play time. They still have 50 seconds left on the man advantage they got for the trip on Powell. So it's going to be interesting to see what Temple can do with this opportunity. You know, only a minute and 15 of power play time, total 50 seconds left on this one. Got to get some scoring chances going, got to go down the ice. You know, capitalize on this momentum, make it a 2-goal game instead of a 1-goal game.
And now Taylor Smith with it, passing it to Dumbach. Dumbach looking for something. He passes it to Ploppert. Ploppert in the corner. Good defense by the Golden Rams right there. And the Owls have to get this puck free since they are running out of power play time. Devlin gets it to Smith. Smith's trying to throw it in front. He gets it wide right. Westchester would try to get it out of the zone, but Powell keeps it in but cannot keep it on his stick. And there are 10 seconds left on this power play for the Owls as they'll have maybe one more opportunity. Taylor Smith with it right here, coming through the zone. And the penalty is over for Westchester. The Owls aren't able to score, but they did do a good job of killing that initial double minor.
Great job on the penalty kill, like you said, Patrick. Unfortunately, the power play did not look as strong. We weren't able to get many scoring opportunities. Now we're right back to even strength.
And just under 12 minutes left in the first. And Westchester looking for something. Jack Pierce now with the puck. Pierce trying to get it to Wojcicki. And that is taken back by Westchester. This is Jake Horacek, the leading scorer for their Golden Rams, the puck. And that one will go right to Rice, and he'll send it back to his defenseman. Westchester looking for a scoring opportunity here. They throw it into the zone. Krulikowski now going after it. But Mango gets to it. Back to Krulikowski. Krulikowski can't handle it, though. That'll go to Horacek. Horacek gives it to Manny Bolognese. Westchester looking for something here. That is shot wide right. Hayden Richards just jumps on it after the rebound, and that'll be a stop.
Liking what we're seeing so far here from Temple. They're having a stronger start than we've seen them have in the past. Maybe, you know, who knows, maybe it was the senior day that inspired them, or maybe it's just a good day to beat Temple. That's how it happens sometimes, but definitely strong start from the Owls. You want to see them keep up this pressure throughout the rest of the game, Patrick. If Temple starts, you know, holding back, you know, trying to defend the lead, they're definitely not going to be in a good position to keep it.
Well, JD, also last week they did have two back-to-back games, one Saturday, one Sunday, and they had a bad loss to Penn State Berks the night before, so that could have been a factor going into the game on Sunday, and they're nice and refreshed for this game here. So maybe that's helping them out.
Absolutely. I mean, energy and stamina is something that's been an issue for the Owls all season with such a short bench, shorter than most teams in this league. So stamina and energy is definitely something that has affected their game so far this season, and something that has not been affecting this game so far.
Westchester won that, and the shot goes right off the stick of Richards and out of play. So 10:27 left in the first. The Owls up 1-0. And JD, if you can see in the corner over there, we have all of the seniors' away jerseys hanging up right there. So that's a nice little touch that they can see every time they go back to that corner.
Definitely nice tribute there to the seniors, the guys who have put in so much work, been such leaders for this program. Nice to see them honored here today.
Now Reed Betzger has it behind the net. Almost a bad turnover there, but Trevs gets it out of the corner. And that shot with a good screen, but Richards falls on that one. 10 minutes now left in the first. Westchester still with the puck in the zone. And another pass in front of the net, but Richards able to keep that one out. And that's going to be a penalty against the Owls. Looks like Dumbach took a tripping penalty. And now Westchester will be on the man advantage for 2 minutes.
Looked like actually it was an interference call on Dumbach. It's going to be a Westchester, right as Westchester's starting to apply some sustained pressure, they are able to get a power play. So it'll be definitely interesting to see how this one shakes out for both Temple and Westchester, because Westchester has seemed to have been turning it up in these last couple minutes.
Well, JD, if the last power play for the Golden Rams is any indication, then it's definitely not going to help their momentum. But maybe they can turn it around this time. Power play is always supposed to help you out. The Owls did do a good job of killing it last time. And the first shot comes early, but a nice stop by Richards, as that's going to be a stoppage of play.
Nice save by Richards on the shot right into the chest. Almost a scoring chance there for Westchester. Is able to fake out the Temple defense a little bit, get some passing lanes open, but luckily the goaltender was able to stop it.
And now Taylor Smith with it. He's looking to get it out of the zone, and he just throws it out. And that'll be a high stick call against the Golden Rams. So an offensive faceoff on a penalty kill is huge here for the Owls.
Like I said, this is huge for the Owls. Maybe they can turn into a scoring chance, but their priority still should be able to get back on defense. Because if Westchester wins this faceoff quick, they can easily get an odd man rush going with a man short for Temple.
And now Powell sending it into the corner. A minute and a half left on this power play. Westchester looking to get something started. Bringing it through the neutral zone right here, but an errant pass as Mango couldn't hold on to it. Krulikowski now fighting for it in the corner. And Westchester comes away with it, but off a stick, and that'll go out of play.
Strong play coming here by Westchester so far in their own power play. They took a defensive zone faceoff during the power play, which is not what you want to do, but they were able to handle that pretty easily and come right down getting a scoring opportunity. It was deflected and went out of play, but Temple's got to watch out here with the offensive zone faceoff for the Golden Rams.
And Devlin will be on the faceoff for the Owls. Westchester wins it. The shot, that's off the blocker of Richards. But Westchester still with possession of the puck. Trevs without a stick right now playing defense, so that could be dangerous. He's just going to try to get his body in the way, and he does. Good job by Trevs. He'll go to pick up a stick as Pierce clears that.
Great defensive play there by Trevs. He was able to intercept the pass to get some much-needed relief of the pressure that Golden Rams have been putting on the Owls on this power play.
And JD, the smallest guy on the ice, able to get his body in front of that without a stick and get the Owls to clear the puck.
Absolutely. Great play by him.
Now Horacek with the puck. Devlin diving to try and poke it away, but unsuccessful. 22 seconds left here, and a shot right there, deflected it looks like, but Richards, no problem with that as he stops another one.
Westchester's doing a great job of screening Richards there on that scoring opportunity. It looks like he didn't really know what the puck, where the puck was. Luckily, last second he was able to locate it, bring it right into his chest for the save to keep this a one-goal lead for the Owls.
And this will be Wojcicki and Mango on the faceoff, and Mango wins it back to his teammate. Westchester with 10 more seconds left, and that shot, and that's a goal. Nice screen in front of the net. That is number 22, Jake Voracek, the leading scorer for the Golden Rams, and that'll tie the game up at one.
The man that we talked about before the game, what a shot from Voracek. He was able to locate the one spot of the net that was open. That's right next to, excuse me, Hayden Richards' left shoulder. So he was able to find that. That shot, nothing you could have really done there. It was just a beautiful shot in a great location. And that's why we talk about Horacek so much. He's the leading scorer. That is his 13th goal on the season and his 27th point. He's been an absolute force here for Westchester early in this season.
And, JD, there's a good screen. It's another pass right there, a one-time opportunity, but Westchester can't bury it. And there was a screen on that goal, so Richards did as much as he could, but he can't stop it if he can't see it.
Absolutely, Patrick. And Temple is really lucky here. This isn't, they're not losing, not losing this game. Westchester's had some great passes, opportunities to wide open shots that have gone awry. I think I've seen two or three so far in this game. They're lucky that it's still just a tie game.
And now a shot off the faceoff, but that hits someone in front and won't make its way to the net. And now Dumbach with the puck, trying to get it to Yaza, but they can't hang on. And that'll go back to Westchester. And this is Mango with the shot, but that's wide right. The Golden Rams still with it. Washington trying to play defense. Giazza now with the puck, and he's going to skate up with it. He's got defense on his tail. He just throws it into the zone, and there will be an offensive line change for the Owls. Devlin with some good D right there, but the Golden Rams able to get it out of the zone. And now an opportunity here. Good save with the pads by Richards. And that's going to be a stoppage. Not sure what's going on here. Maybe a penalty coming.
Cross-check call against, looks like might be the Owls. We'll have to wait to see how this one shakes out to say for sure, though.
And JD, the Owls are falling into their old ways. They were leading in shots 6-3. Now they're down 6-12.
Looks like it's going to be a cross-chest call against Schwartz, which is killer for the Owls. They just let up the goal. Westchester's had all the momentum later here in this period, and now they're going to have a power play too. Very crucial for the Owls to kill this one off. They want to stay in this game.
So Schwartz, 2 minutes for cross-checking, 6.5 minutes left in the period. And a good play immediately to clear it, but Westchester now taking over with the puck. And good job by Powell to get in the way of that pass. Richards will come out to get it. Trevs will try to send it out, but Westchester gets in the way and will keep it in the zone, but Trevs gets it and he sends it down the ice. And now Westchester threatening, but Joey Powell able to get it out of the zone. The Owls will change, and Westchester are chasing after it. A minute already gone on this power play, and no shots generated for the Golden Rams.
Good kill here so far for the Owls. There haven't been many scoring opportunities for the Rams. They can keep this up for another minute. They'll be in a good position to get back in this game.
And the Golden Rams looking for something right here. Passing it back and forth. Another pass. And that shot, and Richards just missed on it. That was Manny Bolognes, who is actually the second leading scorer for the Golden Rams. Don't know what happened there, as Richards just whiffed on it.
That's Bologna's 10th goal of the season. Absolutely a bad play by Richards. That puck was not moving any that too fast, and it just slowly slid into the net. Unfortunate mistake for the Owls. Now they find themselves down a goal. Another power play goal for Westchester in this game.
And JD, we talked about a pregame with last game Kulikowski and Powell taking some bad penalties. This game it's the senior Schwartz that had the power play, the penalty that cost the Owls a goal.
Definitely a costly mistake by both Schwartz, I'm taking that penalty, and by the other senior Richards, who let in that soft goal. Crucial mistakes that will not allow Temple to win these types of games. They gotta tighten up a little bit, not make so many fundamental mistakes, and get back into this game.
And now the Owls playing catch up after a early goal. You thought they would have the momentum. Now Dumbach skating up with it. The points leader, and that's a shot by Wojcina that's easily saved. And JD, we talked about it last game. Anytime Dumbach gets the puck, he looks like he's a man on a mission.
Absolutely.
To try to score a puck.
Absolutely. Dumbach was doing it all by himself in that game. And it looks like it's going to be a penalty on Westchester on that play. Number 16, Andy Skipper, takes that penalty. Didn't really see what it was for, but the Owls are going to be on a two-minute power play, which is huge for them in this game. If they can get a goal on this one, that'll be gigantic for their momentum.
And JD, they have to get something going. If not a goal, at least some pressure. They can't let Westchester keep throwing the puck out of the zone. So we'll see what they can do as Dumbach taking it up right here, passing it to Ploppert, but Ploppert can't get his stick on it. Powell does get to it, giving it to Dumbach. Sorry, that's Devlin. Devlin to Smith. Smith looking for something. He's skating behind the net, gives it back to Devlin. And Devlin's shot redirected by Dumbach, but that's going to go wide. Out to Powell. Powell's shot stopped on a stick by a Westchester player. Trying to get it out are the Golden Rams. They're successful, but the Owls maintain possession. 1:10 left on the power play as Devlin takes it right now. He sends it into Ploppert, but Ploppert hits it wide right. Westchester unable to get it out of the zone. Again, Dumbach to Powell. Now Powell looking for something. He's going to try to get it to Ploppert. And Westchester doing a good job of keeping the Owls off the puck, but Dumbach with it. Smith calling for it. He gets it to Smith, and Smith's shot, that's right into the chest of Rice. Still 40 seconds left on this power play. The Owls do have the puck. Devlin trying to get it to someone in front of the net. He sends it to Powell. Powell's slap shot is saved easily by Rice with a glove. And there's going to be 32 seconds left here on the power play.
That last scoring opportunity started with the man himself. We talked about him all season, Ryan Dumbach. He was able to keep the puck in the zone, skated a little bit, made everybody think he was going to take the shot and found Smith in the right-hand corner. Unfortunately, though, it was a great save by Rice in net, but a wonderful scoring opportunity. If the Owls can keep that up for the next 30 seconds, they may get a goal out of this yet.
And Wojcina wins the faceoff back to Pierce. Kulikowski now with it to Trevs. Trevs shoots it. That stop goes to Wojcina. But Westchester gets it right here. Trying to get out of the zone. They're unable to. Giazza did not see that coming out of his feet. And less than 20 seconds left on this power play. Kulikowski chasing after it.
Got to get something started here for the Owls. You only have 10 seconds left. You can maybe get one more scoring opportunity if you try your best. Try to get a goal during this power play.
And Pierce now with it. 5 seconds left on the power play. Pierce trying to throw it in front, but a defender gets in the way of that. The power play is over, back at even strength, but JD, that was a good power play for the Owls, even if they didn't score.
Wonderful play, and something that, even though they didn't score, something that plays to their advantage, they were able to look pretty hot on that power play and get a lot of pressure, tire out some of these Westchester players. Hopefully they can take the momentum they received from all those scoring chances on that power play and turn it into a goal.
And that's going to be an offsides call right there. Giazza was not expecting it. He was firing a shot. But offsides for the Owls. 2:19 left here in the first period. The Owls down 2-1.
Giazza was not happy about that offsides call, and I don't blame him. I didn't really see much going on there, but the refs have a better view than we do. And he shot the puck, but he was not able to get a scoring chance on that one.
Westchester looking to get something started after they've killed the power play. And that's going to be an icing call. So another good break for the Owls. They'll get an offensive faceoff.
Surprising that the ref called icing on that. It looks like the Westchester player was beating the Temple player to the puck, but it is an icing call. And now Temple will get a offensive zone faceoff. Hopefully they can win that. Looks like it's Nucera on the faceoff. Hopefully we can get that back to Dunbach or Schwartz. Start a scoring opportunity. Start some offensive plays for the Owls.
And Dunbach did win the faceoff. And a great play right there. Nucera got it to Ploppert. And that's going to be a goal to tie the game. You said it, JD. He was trying to get back to Schwartz or Dunbach. He actually got it to Betzker on his left. Betzker gave it back to Nucera. Nucera, a nice, easy one-time goal for Ryan Ploppert.
Definitely play started with Nucera. He won that faceoff, and he also had a beautiful backhand pass to Ploppert. Ploppert scores his first goal of the season on basically what was just putting the puck in an empty net. That play was all Nucera, from faceoff to pass to finish. Wonderful play that puts the Owls back in this game.
So, huge goal with less than 2 minutes left in the first to tie up the game. And a good momentum shift here for the Owls as Nucera has it and then turns it over. Westchester now skating with it. This is number 13, Bolognese, who had the goal to give the Golden Rams the lead. And that puck was right in the corner under Hayden Richards, but the Owls able to get it out of the zone.
1.5 minutes left in this period. If the Owls could keep up the momentum that they got from scoring that goal, they can maybe make this, turn this into a lead either late in this period or if they keep it going to the next one.
And Dunbach trying to get it to Betzker, but that's tipped. That'll go into the zone. Westchester looking to get some of this momentum back. And this is Horacek now with the puck. Schwartz on D. Betzker with some help right there. Good play by the Owls. 1 minute left in the period. And a great glove save there by Richards as Bolognese almost had another goal, but Richards snagged it out of the air.
Bolognese had the back of the net in his sights, but Richards was able to make a beautiful save to stop Westchester from going up by a goal. Bolognese almost had his second goal of the game there, but great play by Richards, like I said, and the Owls are still tied with 1 minute left in this period.
And Westchester wins that faceoff in their offensive zone. And Taylor Smith, a good job to cut off the pass, looking to get something started. Giving it to Devlin. Devlin throws it in. And Rice with a nice little deke right there. Looks like he's going to throw the puck out, but he just let it go to his teammates.
I thought he missed that at first, but looks like that was intentional. Great play by Rice.
And Smith trying to get it to Devlin. And 30 seconds left in the period. Powell with it now in the neutral zone. Powell with a shot, but that's easily saved and throwing it back in front. No one was there though as Seachuk tries to get it back on net. 20 seconds left in the period.
Great awareness there by Seachuk to take that pass, but if you are Powell on that opportunity, it was a 3-on-2 opportunity. He had some passing lanes. I know he wanted to get the shot. You know, he had a goal early in this game, wanted to maybe get another one, but he had some guys over for the pass, maybe try a scoring chance next time.
And now 13 seconds left in the period. The Owls have an offensive faceoff. Hopefully they can get another job going like they did with Nucera. They're sending him out again for the faceoff, so maybe he can get some magic. Actually, he will be out there not taking the faceoff. There will be Powell on the faceoff. Maybe he can get some Nucera magic as he wins it back to Giazza. Giazza loses it, though. Westchester now with the opportunity. A big hit by Krulikowski. 5 seconds left, and that looks like it's going to do it for the first period. Tie game here at Revolution Ice Gardens, 2-2. And that late goal for the Owls was huge, as it looked like Westchester had all of the momentum. But the Owls scored, and JD, one thing that was the turning point was the power play for the Owls. I said they didn't need a goal, but they needed to keep offensive pressure, and they didn't score, but they had 4 shots on the power play, and really, I think that's what the momentum shift was that got them that second goal.
Absolutely. Definitely, you could see the turning point, like you said, was that power play for the Owls. They start off the period being the stronger team than, you know, from about the 15-minute mark to the 5-minute mark or so, maybe a little bit earlier. Westchester really came out hot. They scored those 2 goals off of great plays. The second one was less a great play by Westchester and more a mistake on Temple's part. However, going forward in this game, Temple's going to have to keep up the pressure that we saw at the beginning of this period and at the end of this period. They looked like the better team in both of those instances. And if they're going to want to, you know, break this game open, they're going to have to keep that pressure up throughout an entire period rather than just the beginning or the end.
Well, JD, definitely a stronger first period here for the Owls than we saw last week against Drexel. They were only down, I believe, 3-1 at that point, but you could tell that they were getting outplayed. And right now, they're down on shots 15-12, but I think they're doing a good job right here. And that last goal definitely shifted the momentum. You saw how they were definitely playing better, and they're doing a lot in the offensive zone. They're not doing what they usually do, where they shoot it and then it gets deflected and then goes to the opposite team. They're actually sustaining pressure and getting some good shots.
Absolutely. I mean, 15-12, Temple is down in shots at the end of this first period, but not nearly as big as a margin as we usually see Temple down in shots at the end of the first period. So they're keeping this game close. 15-12 is definitely a fine shot differential for the Owls, like I said, especially considering different ones they've had during the season. So 2-2 game. I'm looking forward to two more periods of great hockey for the Owls.
And JD, that will do it for the end of the first period. Evan Easterling is back on the broadcast. He will be doing the intermission report with you, and then we have a little bit of a surprise coming in for the second period. So you're not going to want to miss that. Be sure to keep it locked,
no,
and we'll be right back. And welcome back in for our first intermission report. We're going to switch it up. I'm going to be doing the intermission report alongside Evan Easterling. And Evan, tied 2-2 at the end of the first. What did you like about that period?
Temple played a good game at even strength, but they were in the box a lot of time. Nucero got 14 penalty minutes with the misconduct. And if they were at even strength more often, then they could have, you know, been up instead of tied at 2.
And actually, both of the goals have come on the penalty kill for Westchester. So definitely, they have to stay out of the box. But they are doing a good job of killing some of the penalties. They did kill Nucero's double minor, which was 4 minutes, and they actually ended up coming on top of that with a power play of their own. So definitely playing good in that aspect. But I agree, they need to stay out of the box because you can't get the get power play opportunities like that for the other team. Anything else that you saw on that?
I do like how Hayden Richards starting in his senior day is coming out atop of the blue paint, challenging shooters. He had that one glove save there in the final minute of the period that I really liked. Came out and challenged the shooter. Took away the top portion of the net, even in the butterfly, because he came out and challenged the shooter. So
yeah.
If the Owls can stay at even strength, I like their chances to win this game.
I do too, Evan. They've played strong so far in the first period. There was a little bit in the middle of the first where they kind of lost the momentum. Westchester definitely had the advantage, but they seem to have gained it back. They tied it up late, and now hopefully they're going to be able to add on to that going into the second period.
Yeah, you got to give credit to Westchester. And they're grinding in the corner, staying gritty in puck battles, and drawing penalties and getting offensive opportunities.
All right, thanks, Evan. That'll do it for the end of the first period intermission. Evan, you'll be back for the second intermission. Let's hope there's some good stuff to talk about for us. Do it. And here we are back for the second period. I'm joined by Dylan Coyle. Dylan is a high school at Oxford Area High,
yes.
And he's actually joining in for the broadcast. He's hoping to come to Temple, hoping to join the ice hockey broadcast next semester, so we got him in right now.
Absolutely, yes. As Patrick was saying, I'm a senior at Oxford Area High School. It's basically etched in stone at this point that Temple's going to be the place that I go to. Not official, but it will be. But definitely, I've always wanted to be a sports broadcaster since I was in fourth grade, so I really appreciate the opportunity that you guys have given me today.
Well, we always love people that are fans of the broadcast, and great for you to come out. So you watched a little bit of the first period. What do you expect coming into this game?
You know, from the past few games, now Temple's been on a bit of a losing streak, obviously. They're really coming out with some fire on senior day. Definitely, they got the first goal very early on. Two goals quickly from Westchester came back. But at the end of the period, Temple was able to even the game. Now, what we've seen a lot from Temple is the discipline is not there. Now, the Owls have taken a few penalties, including a double minor, and that's cost them in this game so far.
Yeah, and both of the goals for the Golden Rams have come on the power play, so you can't have your goalie trying to stop the power play shot. The one was a screen that he just let in. The second one, we can kind of blame it on Richard,
yeah,
that he just missed that. But
no, actually, it was deflected, that goal.
Was
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it was right there. It was hard to tell because it was right around the dot in the circle. It hit something and just completely changed directions.
Well,
so
then we can't blame Richard for that. It's just a good play then. But two power play goals. It's tied right now, and it could be a little bit different. But I am liking the way the Owls are handling their power plays. In the past, they haven't been too successful. But even today, they haven't gotten any power play goals, but they have sustained pressure and
yes,
definitely tired out the defense.
Yes, and they've had 12 shots on goal. The Golden Rams have had 15. So it has been an even game, except for that middle chunk where Westchester started to control it. Temple started to gain momentum at the end of that period, so hopefully we'll see the Owls start to play with that fire that they came out with and that they ended that period with.
And the goals for the Owls have come on the stick of Powell and Ploppert. And that second one by Ploppert was just a great play by Dan Nucera to win the faceoff, get the puck, do the one-time pass. And Ploppert had nothing to do except just bury that puck.
It was an empty net, basically, for Ploppert. It was a beautiful pass. It deceived most people on the ice. It deceived me. I was just watching it right here. So definitely a fantastic assist there. Hopefully we see more of that from Temple. They've definitely, and it's a senior day, so you can have that kind of adrenaline that comes through the team. So I'm excited. This period should be an indicator of how, of course, third period will go down as Temple starts to come back onto the ice, of course. So definitely excited to see what the Owls will be able to do here.
And Dylan, the hardest play to defend in hockey is the one-time shot. So we've already seen one goal from each side on the one-timer. So we'll hope that that the Owls can keep it going as they're coming back on the ice right now. So the second period is about to get underway.
And we are underway for the start of the second period, and the Golden Rams win the faceoff, and they're going to start off with this. Again, the score is 2-2. If you're just joining us, the Westchester Golden Rams, they actually had a 2-1 lead until late in the first period. The Owls were able to come back. Shots are 12-15 in favor of the Golden Rams, and immediately at center ice, it's intercepted, and here come the Owls the other way. It's offside warning. They're going to have to peel back. And the Golden Rams will get another possession to start this period. Over across, deflected, still staying in the neutral zone. Golden Rams get into the Temple zone. Still trying to go around, and finally Giazza and the Owls break out with it. Wushner chases it. Getting checked on behind the net. Still back there. Giazza comes in to help. Swung around the corner. The Golden Rams are going to try and clear it. They do, but as far as Krulikowski, and he's going to just send it right back in almost. Almost hit the ref right there. That would not have been good.
And you know, Dylan, these refs, they're out there, and they've got to dodge pucks. They've got to dodge players, and they look like acrobats out there sometimes, jumping and sliding and doing what they do.
It's a very dangerous job, and there's no home rink for them, so it's always something to look out for. Golden Rams down deep behind the net. Richards has had a great game so far. Can he sustain it right here? Puck, it's swatted out, and here comes Taylor Smith trying to go after it. He's not going to be the first to get there. It's actually Michael Rice who's able to just swat it away. It's still in the zone, however. Trying to chase it. That's Devlin in the corner. Westchester gets possession of the puck, passes it by Smith, and gets it for himself. Temple's having a lot of good sustained pressure. It looks like they're covering a lot of the neutral zone right now. Into the zone, behind the net. Smith is after to chase it. Westchester does have possession, finds a speeding player to the left side. McLaurie trying to hit it down, does not work, and Temple gets it. Long outreach pass to Smith, who's been on for over a minute at this point. Smith always seems to be one of the players that you can spot that is on the ice for extended shifts.
Well, he's one of the upper-class leaders on this team, Dylan. He's always out there with a stick on the puck and just making plays out there.
And it's Plopper the other way. Cannot get anything there. Smith was the one who passed it to him, and he finally peels off for a change. Powell scored one of the goals for the Owls earlier in this game. Getting checked on by two Golden Rams into the corner. Help comes from Plopper. This line responsible for two of the goals so far. Betzger tries to feed it out in front. Does not work, and here come the Golden Rams the other way, 2-on-1. Temple's going to have to hurry back if they want to have some defensive efforts here. Tries to go in the middle. There's a shot off the mask of Richards. Hayden Richards with a beautiful save, and it was gloved down. It's going to be a hand pass, and my, oh my, would that sting him.
And Dylan, that was a good play by Seachuk getting back there to get in front of the pass, and he forced the pass to the guy coming in the center, and Richards just got in the way of it. And we were talking about Smith and him always being in the ice. Ryan Dumbach, just leading point scorer on this team, and he's just always in the mix, no matter what the Owls are doing, offense or defense. And he's only a junior, so look for him to return next year and be a factor, maybe even turn that A into a C on his jersey.
And Ryan Dumbach, of course, is a defenseman, offensive defenseman at that, with 31 points in his entire season so far. Definitely one of the top players on this team, and I think a lot of players can look at him as a leader of the Owls. After the icing face-off to the right of Richards, there's a shot. It deflects out of play into the netting.
And Dylan, Dumbach is the president of this club team, so definitely a lot of responsibility for the junior. And if I had to guess, he would definitely be the captain next year with Krulikowski graduating.
We were talking about it right before this period started. Dan Nucera with a beautiful pass earlier to get that second goal for the Owls. But Westchester, look out, pass in front. It almost went in. It went off the edge of his stick. He wasn't able to come around on it, and it stays 2-2. Shot from the point. It's saved by Richards, and he covers it up.
And that was a good play by the Golden Rams. They couldn't get the goal to fall, and Richards, there's been a couple of plays where he's just been on the ground in a wide open net that the Golden Rams have not been able to capitalize on.
Richards comes into this game with an .844 save percentage, and he's definitely helping that rise right now. 15 saves on 17 shots so far. Puck is dropped. The Owls win it, but it's staying in the zone. Trying to come down deep. Into the corner now. It's Belones. Gets it behind the net. Devlin wraps him up. Up to the point. Coming on in a slot. No shots taken right there. It didn't get to the net, and the Owls are going to try and move it up. Not able to, however. It stays into the zone. Trying to swat it away, he does. Murray's over to it. It goes past the Westchester player. That was Bill Swall right there, and goes all the way to the other end. So Westchester is definitely getting the majority of possession early in this game, and Devlin comes on in and tries to hit him. Knocked him off the puck almost, but he still comes away with it.
Now, Dylan, it looks like Westchester right now has a lot of the momentum. A lot of this period so far, about a quarter of the way through, has been played in the Owls' defensive zone, and they just need to get something started.
Brennan Murray went over his stick and out to the neutral zone for Westchester to regroup again. C. McCleary decided not to go over to that. And here comes the Owls with Matthew Krulikowski. Gets it across into the middle. It's given away, though. Coming right back onto the ice, that was Charles Giazza. He kept that from being a break the other way. Behind, and then it's rolled around. Into the corner now. Westchester tries to get out in front. There's a big save right point blank by Hayden Richards. Oh, that was so close to being a 3-2 game, but he keeps them in it. Here comes Temple the other way. Just went off the stick. And wow, Richards keeping them in this game continuously in this period.
That was almost a bad play defensively for the Owls. Trebs was fighting for the puck, and then there was just a shot from point blank, but Richards got his body in front of it. And he's not a big guy, so for him to get his body in front of it, that's a good job by him.
Wushner with a shot. It's a blocker save. It almost handcuffed him. Michael Rice keeping them in this as well. Both goalies have had a great game so far. Into the middle. No one's home for it. Trying to chase it. Westchester has it. Giazza gets it. Down deep. It's Pierce. Into the corner. Westchester still trying to get away from him. It's a fight for it. Out in the front. There was a shot. It hit something. It went behind and then it rolled to the other corner. Giazza tried to come down low and get it. It did not work. And here comes Westchester the other way. Tom Cole with speed. Goes behind the net. Trying to look out for options out front. Still controlling it. Swartz is trying to get on him. He still has it, however. And here comes the Owls the other way. But it's taken back from him. It's Tom Cole again. Westchester keeping alive in their zone. It's finally thrown out there. Could have been a 2-on-1 break right there, but it looks like there will be an interference penalty. Not quite sure who it is against.
Looks like it's going to be
on Westchester, it appears, maybe.
Number 23 right there, that is Kyle Laughlin. So the Owls with a good break right there. They'll go on the power play for 2 minutes with 13:55 left here in the period.
The power play for the Owls is not something we've seen so far that much in this game, but this is an opportunity for them to take the lead again. So definitely a prime opportunity. Laughlin will be in the box for 2 minutes over that interference call, and the first power play line is out for the Owls. Puck is won by Westchester. Breaking down low, though. Powell, that is. Sends it around to the other side. Dumbach gets it across. Over the stick. Thrown out of play. And it hit the netting.
And a good showing right there. They didn't generate a shot on that right there for the Owls, but you want to keep the puck in your zone as much as you can. Tire out the defense so you can get some more scoring opportunities, and they're doing that right now.
Devlin wins the puck back. It's Taylor Smith. Smith to Dumbach. Dumbach with a shot. Pad save by Rice, and it's one out of the zone. That was a good pad save there. Dumbach had a clear opportunity. There were players in front. The screen did not work, though, and here come the Owls the other way. It's Smith across Powell. Powell trying to go across the zone. Carries in it himself. Goes into the middle. There's a speeding Devlin. Devlin with a backhander. It's wide. Powell behind the net. Tries to feed it out in front. It does not go. Close opportunities there. Taylor Smith gets it down. It's Nucero. Smith. Smith wants for the shot. Deflected. Just a save by Rice. It almost got in. Deflections are extremely tricky if you're a goaltender.
If you can't see where that puck is coming from or if it changes direction midway through the shot, there's nothing you can really do. Just hope you can get in the way of it.
54 seconds left in this Owl power play. A lot of opportunities, but nothing is going in. Dumbach speeding across the left wing side. Takes it in himself. Tries to go into the middle. It's Wushner. Can't get it out in front. Westchester pressuring. No one's on that defensive point, and it's cleared all the way to the other end of the ice.
Now, there's still 30 seconds left. The Owls have an opportunity to do something on this power play, but Westchester doing a good job of killing it so far.
Taylor Smith. He had to roll back. Leo Flick was on him. And Murray just sends it down deeper. Trebs. Down into the corner. It's Charles Giazza. Back up to the point. Krulikowski just barely kept it in. Trying to keep it in again, but it looked like there was a bit of a hook there. No call is going to be made, however. The power play is over. A lot of opportunities. Nothing was going in, however. The Owls are still trying to pressure. 2 men in the corner. Trying to get it back out in front. Charles Giazza backhands it behind the net. Into the corner again. Ploppert's there. It squirts out. but it doesn't get out of the zone. Good play by Trevs to keep it in. That fight on the boards is still alive here. Finally out to the neutral zone, and Trev's going to have to skate back. And there's a line change going on for Westchester right now. A quick change, though, has to be, because Ploppert almost got that puck. It deflected off his stick and into the zone. No icing there. Ploppert still chasing it. Westchester trying to move it out. They do, but only as far as near the blue line. And a lot of opportunities right now for Temple.
Yeah, Dylan, that play right there, the Owls had an odd man rush with Westchester changing, and Ploppert just couldn't keep the puck on a stick and generate an opportunity.
Nucero takes it away, tries to feed it out to another Temple player, but it did not work.
See, Dylan, they're testing you here with a no-name, no-number right there for the Owls. We don't even know who that is. It's either Dan Farkas or Christopher Shannon. But we may never know.
We may never know. I was being tested. I said a Temple player. I said I would tell. I told you I would say a Temple player. It might have been a little noticeable, though, right there. Westchester loses the puck. Does not stay into the zone. They're going to have to catch up and tag up. And Trevs passes it across to the other side. It's Krulikowski, the captain of the Temple Owls. Two players on them. A nice play to swing it across. Trevs just dumps it into the zone. Westchester gets it first, and puck is swung out into the crowd. I don't believe it hit anyone, but look out.
That was a dangerous play right there. The puck, there's not enough netting to cover the stands right here at Revolution Ice Gardens, and that one just went right to the crowd. Luckily, it did not hit anyone.
Patrick, has a puck ever come up here?
Luckily, no. I don't think I'd be able to stop that right there. I probably would get knocked out by it, so it's probably a good thing that we've never had to test our abilities over here.
That's probably true. That's a true statement. Anyway, Devlin to Dumbach. Dumbach gets the puck. There's a shot deflection. Score! There was a deflection in front. Dumbach shot from the point. Got in. And Temple leads the game 3-2. I believe it was Taylor Smith who had deflected off of. It was missing on the left side, but it went in. Rice could not see it to his left. And from a face-off win, that's why they're so important. Dumbach with the shot from the point, and Temple takes the lead, and Billy Joel decides to play for us right now.
Dylan, I'm going to have to yell at you right there. That was not Billy Joel. That was
Bruce Springsteen. Patrick, listen.
We might have to kick you off right here. That was Born to Run right there.
I don't know why I said Billy Joel, but listen. Bruce Springsteen, he's also the man, and I'm in a Billy Joel mood. I was listening to a bunch of music by him on the way up. I heard that, and he's on my Spotify. Born to Run is on my Spotify account, so my apologies, Patrick.
Dylan, I'm not going to blame you there. Billy Joel is a great artist, but I'm pretty sure every person from New Jersey might have gotten mad at you after they said that.
Listen, and I understand that. I apologize. Bruce is a fantastic artist, and I'm just going to throw my head back in shame because that was, oof.
Well, Dylan, talking about that.
I know this is Rocky. This is Rocky Balboa. Love this.
Talking about that goal, though, Dumbach's shot, it actually might have been deflected by two players. It might have been first hit by Devlin and then Powell buried it. And that was a great play, as you said, coming off the faceoff to give the Owls the goal advantage.
Absolutely. I couldn't quite see who got that on the stick. I thought it was Taylor Smith. But I'm not sure. Did you see Devlin got it, or?
It looked like it was Dumbach's shot. It looked like Devlin hit it to the left of Rice, and then that went right to Powell, who was to the right of Rice, and he just buried it.
That means it's 3-2 to the Owls, and Westchester now is playing behind once again. They were already playing behind at the start of the game. They scored two goals unanswered to take the lead. Hopefully the Owls can keep the momentum going here on Senior Day. Dumbach trying to get out of the zone. Cannot do it. It stays in, but it's finally swallowed away. And here's a 2-on-1 break for the Owls the other way. Pass it in front. Big save. There's another shot. Rebound. It's going around the crease, and it's back behind the net. That was a great opportunity. Back out in front. There was a whiff there in the middle. Couldn't quite see who had it. Dumbach to the other side of the ice. Trying to get options going. There's another shot, and it's wide on net, and a penalty will be called. From all the pressure that the Owls were putting on the Golden Rams, they're going to be rewarded with okay power play.
And that was a great play. The 2-on-1, Steve Pierce was able to get it to Giazza. Giazza's great shot, but that was saved by Rice. And then Dumbach got the rebound, and he just tried to flick it in with the backhand, and Rice was just right there for it. But a good play by the Owls, and they were able to draw the penalty to be on the advantage for 2 minutes.
Absolutely, and hopefully they'll be able to get other scoring opportunities here. They were already getting a lot of them on their previous power play. They were not able to convert there. But definitely can keep up the pressure. And with that goal that just came, the opportunity to pad their lead is here. Dumbach to the other side. Smith from the pass from Dumbach. Gets it back, though. Dumbach all the way to the other side. There was a saucer pass. Tried a one-timer from Nucero. It did not go. And the puck is shot out of play off the glass and into the stands. But no heads were harmed in that one.
That's always a positive. That one didn't even make it to the fans. That fell actually between the bleachers and the ice. So that actually might be gone forever, lost underneath the bleachers there.
Patrick Devlin won the faceoff. It's Taylor Smith. Below the net, Nucero. And it's Powell now. Joey Powell tries to get to Nucero. Nucero tries to swack it out. And it did not go, and it swung on to the other end of the ice. Great opportunity already.
And they're doing some good job on this power play. They haven't gotten a great opportunity yet, but as long as they're throwing pucks at the net, nothing bad can come of that.
Pass in the middle, Dumbach score! What a beautiful play from Taylor Smith, and Ryan Dumbach finishes it. It's 4-2 on the power play.
Well, Dylan, we talk about him, the leading scorer for the Owls, and he gets it done. But let's not forget the great pass by Taylor Smith. It looks like he was losing the puck at first. He just threw it to Dumbach. Dumbach buried it. A great shot to the left of Rice, and that'll put the Owls up two, and that will be a power play goal. So all that pressure pays off for them.
They are 0-2 in the season series versus Westchester, and today that could change. Of course, that was Bruce Springsteen after that goal.
We switched it up on you. We had Billy Joel the first time, but we decided to put it in the
just
box.
Just stop it.
Time.
There's an opportunity. Big save by Richards. It looked like the other opportunity could not go in. And here comes Betzger the other way. Temple, check laid on him. Nucero swings it back out. It's taken away by Westchester and Manny Belones. Belones just throws it up. Mango gets a speeding player across. Into the corner now. Betzger gets it away. Just a little too in front of him. It could have been a break going the other way. It's a cross. Westchester moves in the other way. Belones passes it out to the middle. Nothing going on here. Shot from the point. It's a weak one. It's knocked down by Trevs. Now that shot was by Horacek. He's Jake Horacek. Of course, not Jake Voracek, but it's very close to that. Horacek is the top point getter for the Golden Rams with 26 points in his season so far. Just a fantastic player for them, and they're going to have to look on him and lean on him if they're going to want to come back in this game. Here comes Westchester the other way. It's Belones now. Manny Belones thinking about a cross crease. Goes into the middle. It somehow did not go, though. It looked like a player got in front of it. Into the corner now. Golden Rams swinging around. McClory, there's a shot, and it's gloved down by Richards.
Now, Dylan, you're talking about Horacek a little bit right there, and he's definitely the Ryan Dumbach of the Golden Rams. He's the leading point scorer. He's a forward, so he's scored a little bit more goals than Dumbach has, but he has definitely gotten a lot of opportunities for Westchester so far this game and definitely during the season.
Absolutely. Face-off won by the Owls, but it swung around. Westchester has possession. Up to the point, comes on in, there's a shot, and a save by Richards. Temple's going to try and move it out, and they have the puck, and the possession. The other way, Swartz trying to chase it, cannot get to it. Giazza's chasing it, through his legs, Westchester's trying to break out. But the good forechecking there by Wushner, and Giazza keeps the Westchester Golden Rams at bay for the time being. But here they come on the breakout. Thrown into the zone. 5:24 left in this fast-paced, high-scoring second period for Temple. Into the corner. It's still going around. Backhanded. Krulikowski's trying to get over to it. Swartz cannot reach it. Westchester is still controlling it. At the point, Skipper sends it in. They've had possession for almost a minute at this point. Players are getting tired for the Owls. In the corner, the puck isn't moving. Finally scores three. There's a slap shot, and it came out of Richards' possession, and no damage was done right there.
And Dylan, actually right there, if you were noticing, the defenseman actually switched sides right before that puck came out, and that was almost a great opportunity for the Golden Rams.
Absolutely, and here's another opportunity. The other way, Westchester. Good play by Taylor Smith, and there looks like there's going to be a power play again coming up for the Owls. Possibly a slash from what I saw. The referee, let's see what he will indicate, but this means that another power play, yes, it is a slash, will be coming for the Owls.
And Dylan, one thing I didn't like about that play right there is that Taylor Smith got slashed, and instead of keeping playing, he was looking for the penalty, which he got, and that could have cost an opportunity for the Owls.
Absolutely. You have to play to the whistle. And that's something that's, of course, very prominent in soccer. Of course, you have to play to the whistle. But hockey, too. If you don't know if that's going to be called, you need to keep playing. Taylor Smith, left side, gets it into the middle. Shot wide, rebound from the boards. It did not go. Backhanded out to the neutral zone. But, yes, absolutely, you need to play until the whistle.
And if he didn't get that penalty right there, he would have just squandered an opportunity that he could have had because he was looking for a penalty.
Dumbach across to the other side, deflected, goes into the Golden Rams bench area, and the play is stopped. 3:55 to go, and Temple, they're having a fantastic period.
And it's been a pretty quick period right now, more than three quarters of the way through, and it's just flown by, and the Owls have done a very good job. And for the last couple of minutes, Westchester's had a lot of momentum, but the Owls definitely had it to begin this period.
Shorthanded opportunity. Jake Horacek, his shot was deflected up into the netting, so the faceoff will be to the right of Hayden Richards. Joey Powell's in there for the Owls. You can see the defenseman for the Westchester Golden Rams, Kevin Cleary, is already back into the neutral zone. It's shorthanded, so you don't want to take too many risks. Almost an opportunity for the Golden Rams, but the Owls take it back and will try to start up. Off the stick of Dumbach. He's going to chase it down the left wing side. Dumbach looking for options. Still looking into the middle. There's a shot just wide of the net. It fluttered off of a stick, and Dumbach controls it again. Behind the net, a quick pass out in front. It's still in the crease. Where is it? Who can get possession of it? And it's the Golden Rams. Swall just throws it out to the other end of the ice. Poor checks there, though. Richards is going to have to be careful with it. With 55 seconds left to go, this has been an interesting power play.
And almost a huge opportunity for the Golden Rams, as Horacek was the first player back to get to that puck, but Richards was able to beat him. And if Horacek actually pressed on that, he might have been able to take the puck back from Richards, but he just retreated, as they are on the penalty kill.
The Owls are having a tough time on the breakout in this power play. I believe Westchester's pressure with one man going into the zone of forecheck is definitely helping out. But Nucero gets it back to the point. Trevs across, Ryan Dumbach, left wing side, to the other side, there's a shot, saved down, another shot, rebound went into the netting. Man, oh man, the opportunities that Temple is getting in this period has been outstanding.
And they've definitely outplayed the Golden Rams so far this period. They definitely probably knew that you were coming on to the broadcast.
Oh,
they wanted
wow.
to give you a good period to call.
Listen, I appreciate every single one of you Temple Owl players for doing that for me. It's been a blast. Almost the end of the second period. 2 minutes, 30 seconds to go, and also almost the end of this power play. 10 seconds remaining in that. Owls have it in the defensive zone, trying to break out. Ploppert swings it around. It's Charles Giazza on it now. Lets it, watches it go by to the point, into the middle. There's a pass down low. Could not do anything about it. Play was a broken one, but Temple still has possession. Westchester now. Two on two the other way. Trying to go cut inside. Horacek is brought down, and it looks like a holding call will be made here. Delayed penalty on the ice. Owls will be shorthanded. 6-on-5 now. The goalie has come off. Cologne's thinking about a shot. takes one, deflected, it's still loose. Where is it? It's finally swatted away by a Temple player, and the whistle finally blows. So Jay Korachek using his speed and draws the penalty.
Well, that's going to be on the captain, Krulikowski, and he had a bad penalty taken last game against Drexel. The Owls were about to go on the power play, and then after the whistle, he made a hit, which made it even strength, and Drexel actually scored on that 4-on-4. So we'll see how the Owls play without their captain on the ice for 2 minutes, but there's a minute 43 left in the period, so barring a goal by the Golden Rams, they will still have a power play going into the third.
5-on-4. It could be a carryover penalty. That's what they want, absolutely. They don't want to give anything up. Richards makes the save and covers it. Now, the penalty-killing unit right now is Charles Giazza. It's Wushner, Dumbach, and Swartz out right now, and we haven't seen them out since around the first period. It's been a great one for Temple in the discipline department. We were talking about that before this one started. Back up to the point. To the left side. Back again. There's a slap shot. Save by Richards.
And Dylan, you're talking about the penalties by the Owls. That's something that Evan talked about in his intermission report. They can't be taking these penalties, and so far in the second, they've been able to avoid that.
The puck is now in the hands of Kevin Cleary. Back to Bill Swall. Westchester carries it over. Cleary looks for options. Trying to look up to the point. Goes low with it. Let's it go by him. It's down low. Swall now. Gets it even deeper. Swall with the one-timer. It's wide of the net. It almost bounced out right in front. It's on the netting. Where is it? Ballones finds a player. It's Swall breaking inside, and Temple clears it.
Good play there by the Owls. Left. As Richards was able to stop a couple pucks. One went wide of the net, and then the Owls were able to get it out. Get a nice line changes. There's still 20 seconds left here in the period.
20 seconds left in this period. They hope that this penalty kill will still go on to the other. That would mean that Westchester would not score. Bill Swall now gets it back up top. Think about the shot. Wrist shot. It's wide of the net. 7 seconds left. Westchester still has possession. And it's back up to the top. Two players collide. It's out to the zone. And that is the end of the second period. Temple scores 2 goals in beautiful fashion. Right now, the score is 4-2, and just what a fantastic period for the Temple Owls.
Well, the Owls definitely had the momentum for most of that, and I do want to talk about a very good job by Devlin there at the end of the period to get the puck out of the zone. It looked like he could collide with another player. They were both on the ice, and he just poked it out of the zone, so good job on the penalty kill.
Absolutely, and I think the power play unit, I believe they had 3 power play opportunities there. Just a fantastic job of generating opportunities to get on the score sheet. They got 1 power play goal from the period, and that was another beautiful play. Taylor Smith was carrying it over and went into the middle. It got on the Dumbach stick, and the one we were talking about, who is the top player for the Owls, puts another one to pad the lead. So it's 4-2 at this intermission, and what do you want to see from the Owls moving forward?
I want to see a second period going into the third. They played very well. They outscored the Golden Rams 2-0, and they had, like I said, they had a lot of the momentum, and they, even when they weren't scoring, they were keeping the puck in the zone, and Westchester was definitely on its heels most of the period, except for that last power play that they got at the very end. And shots are pretty much even right now, 24 for the Owls, 27 for the Rams. So Hayden Richards right now, 25 saves, which is very impressive. And he's doing a good job there in net.
Hayden Richards has been one of the key factors in keeping this game, well, now it's in Temple's favor. So definitely he's a factor on this ice. Westchester and Temple. Westchester has won the first 2 meetings so far. Right now it's 4-2. Temple could be looking to beat Westchester in their last meeting of the season. Well, we will see you for the intermission report. I'm actually done here. Well, that was awesome. Thank you so much.
Dylan, you did a great job.
I appreciate that.
I'm glad we gave you this opportunity, and thanks for coming on. And hopefully this isn't a goodbye, but I'll see you later. Hopefully you'll be back
100%.
On the broadcast next season and calling some games and getting involved with this team.
100%. You will see me next year.
You heard it here first, folks.
All right.
So that'll do it for our second intermission. JD will be back on the broadcast with Evan Easterling for the intermission report, so keep it locked right here.
All right.
And welcome back to Revolution Ice. I am back on the call alongside Evan Easterling here. So, Evan, during that second period, Temple had a lot of scoring chances, especially on the power play. Comment on their ability to capitalize on their power play opportunities.
Yeah, the power play worked really well in the second period, and part of that was due to the net front presence. They moved the puck well, and that generated shooting lanes, so when they did throw pucks at the net, they weren't just getting blocked and cleared back down the ice. They were getting through to the goalie, and the goalie was forced to make saves, and then the net front presence caused some deflections, and that's how they got both their goals in the period.
Absolutely. Definitely a strong period so far for the Owls, like you said, on the power play, but also even strength. Now, let me ask you, what do the Owls have to do here going forward in the third period to keep this lead, keep the momentum, and get a win out here today?
Too many times I've watched a hockey game, and the team sits on the lead when they're in the third period, up by a goal or two, and then the game winds up going to overtime. So they can't sit on the lead. They have to continue to play well at both even strength and at the man advantage when they get those opportunities. They'll have 18 seconds of a penalty to kill when the third starts. That's the first step, and then from there, they'll have to play well, even strength, and try to get a third goal.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for being here, Evan, and commenting on that. We will be back here. I'll be alongside Patrick Johnstone for the third period. Thanks for being here, Evan.
No problem.
And welcome back. We're back with our guy that does the color commentary, JD Fogarty.
Heck of an introduction.
I forgot what I was trying to say right there. I was trying to give you a big hype up, but I've got nothing.
I think
for
everybody's
you,
really hyped for me now. Yeah, thanks a lot.
Well, JD, we definitely missed you for that second period, but
I don't think
the Owls did. They really turned it up as soon as you got off the broadcast, so they might have heard that and tried to spite you.
Absolutely not. I don't think they missed me at all. I was over there watching the game, and very strong second period. They even have a little bit of a power play going into the third. You know, Evan said it best in the intermission report, the way that if the Owls want to keep this lead, they got to just keep going. They got to get more goals. They can't be satisfied with 2-goal lead. They can't sit back on their haunches and, you know, wait for the game to end. They got to, you know, keep this aggressive play up, maybe get another goal, you know, get a little bit of a cushion. That's how they're going to win this game going down the stretch.
Yeah, JD, that was a very good period. They do still have 18 seconds of penalty kill with the Krulikowski penalty, but they definitely outplayed Westchester for the second period. And the third period, though, is where they usually have their problems with the short bench. They get tired, and then that's where you start letting the goals. And we saw it against Drexel last weekend. They really just looked very flat in the third period, so they're going to have to combat that and keep a hold on this lead.
Absolutely. The lucky thing here for the Owls is Westchester, I think, has one or two players more than the Owls, but not many. They have a very similarly stacked team in terms of the bench. So Temple does have a short bench, but so does Westchester, relatively. Excuse me. So hopefully, stamina, of course, is an issue. You know, when you have so little people on the bench, it's going to be an issue every game. You can't stop it from being an issue. But hopefully Westchester will run into similar problems, and they can be evenly matched going deep into this game.
So we're about ready to get started with the third period. The Owls still have not come out of their locker room, though, so not too sure where they are. The coaches are out there, but the players, maybe they're going with the bold strategy of sending no one out on the ice and see what happens.
I mean, it's bold, but, you know, it just might work. Just crazy enough to work.
JD, I'm going to have to go ahead and say that it wouldn't work, but I'm also going to go ahead and say that they're not going to do that. So
yeah,
that's something we don't have to worry about.
Here they come,
led by their fearless goalie, Hayden Richards. Nice intro music for them as well. The beat dropping as they're coming out onto the ice. And, JD, you weren't on for the second period, but I do want to talk about that goal that I believe Powell deflected in. It was off the faceoff. Dumbach got it. He threw it in front. I believe Devlin deflected it first, and then Powell sent it in. And this was a beautiful play. Nothing Rice could have done with the deflections. And the Owls did play very well. They had a lot of offensive pressure. And what's funny is they still got outshot that period.
Absolutely.
Or it was even shots. I believe it was 12-12 on the shots. And they outscored the Golden Rams 2-0.
Absolutely. Like you said, that Powell goal, was huge for the Owls. He's been playing well for the Owls all game. He may make an appearance if things go well for us the game in my 3 stars of the game. Let's not count our eggs before they hatch. So he has played very well in this game so far for the Owls. And, yeah, if they want to keep this going, they got to go deeper down the stretch, and they got to, you know, get some things going and hopefully come out strong at the start of this period and play an evenly matched game with Westchester.
Yeah, we're ready to get started for the third. It's Wojcicki and Giazza out there with Swartz and Dumbach. Sorry, the puck dropped, so here we are back to the game. And the Owls are about to kill the rest of this Matt Krulikowski power penalty as they just sent it down. And they're back at even strength here early in the third. And Westchester with it right now. They're going to look to get something started. And it looks like it's Mango maybe back there with that puck. And Westchester still looking to get something going. This is Horacek with it, the leading scorer for the Golden Rams. He's looking for a teammate, gets it to Mango. Mango shot, though, off of Giazza. And Westchester looking for something still back behind the net. Swartz chasing after it. Mango will get there first. But here comes Pierce shaking off some defenders, but he loses the puck. And now Swartz fighting for it. Giazza comes away with it. He gets it out of the zone. And then Giazza tries to send it down, and that's not going to be touched. And no icing called there, as it looks like Pierce was able to get to it. And a good opportunity right here for Westchester. This is Colby Yowler with it. And still in the zone for the Golden Rams. They still have an opportunity. Swartz gets to it, however. Gets it to Powell. Powell up to Giazza. Giazza can't get it in the zone. A good defensive play there by Valerio for the Golden Rams. Westchester still with an opportunity. That shot is deflected. Richards throws his pad out there. The puck is still bouncing around in front of the net. Looks like Powell was in there helping Richards.
What a play there by Richard. He was able to get his right pad on a puck that was destined for the back of the net, and he was able to keep this at a two-goal deficit. Beautiful save by the senior.
And that puck will go out of the zone, so Westchester will have to do it again. A line change for the Owls could have been deadly, but Richards catches that and lets it go to Trevs. And now the Owls passing back and forth. This is the captain, Krulikowski, with it to Smith. Smith taps it right into the zone. But that will be an icing called, as it looks like Smith did not get it far enough into the neutral zone.
Almost a scoring opportunity there for the Golden Rams as Steve McElroy had it right at the blue line with only one Temple defender in and another one of his players coming up the right-hand side. But he was not able to make the play happen, so Temple got lucky on that one as they could have been facing a pretty difficult-to-stop scoring chance from the Golden Rams.
And now Taylor Smith with the puck, passing it to Devlin. Devlin throws it into the zone. The Owls now chasing after it, but Westchester will get there first. That's Skipper. And Trez throws it in, and that's going to be a high stick, but Westchester gets it, so no call. Now a two-on-two opportunity. The shot right there, good save by Richards. There was a rebound, but Westchester could not get onto it. Nucero trying to get something doing with it. He passes it. Ekins out of the zone. Smith now picking it up. Good play right there. That's going to be a penalty coming against Westchester. And the Owls will be on a man advantage for 2 minutes now.
Looks like it's an interference call on Westchester. He hit the Temple defender, number 16. Andy Skipper hit the Temple defender, and he knows it right in front of the scorer's box there. And now the Owls are going to be in a two-minute power play. Evan mentioned it in the intermission report, Patrick. Owls were huge on the power play in the second period. Let's see how they can do on their first one here in the third.
Well, that was a good play by Taylor Smith. He did last period, actually, where he got the puck and drew a penalty. And let's see what the Owls can do with this now. As Giazza with it gives it to Krulikowski. Krulikowski turns the puck over, but Trevs tried to keep it, and he was unable to.
Scoring opportunity there, or at least an opportunity set up a scoring opportunity. Excuse me, came all there from Giazza. The puck was about to go right to the Westchester defender's stick, but he batted it out of the air to himself. Was able to pass back to his defender. Unfortunately, nothing came of it. Now Temple has the puck again.
It was a bad turnover by Krulikowski, but a shot right here that goes wide left. Trevs now keeping it in. Giazza chasing after it, but Swall gets there before the Temple defense can, and that'll be cleared the length of the ice all the way back down to Richards.
A couple good scoring chances or scoring opportunities set up here so far for the Owls in the first 30 seconds of their power play, but if they want to turn those scoring opportunities into the goals, they got to be more aggressive going forward here in this man advantage.
Now Krulikowski with it to Trevs. Trevs the shot, good save by Rice. Trevs unable to keep it in the zone, so about halfway through this power play for the Owls, nothing doing so far. They've only generated one shot on net. But Krulikowski trying to get it to Powell, but that was a hard pass. Now Krulikowski skating up of it. Time is ticking away. Nucero's up by the blue line looking for a pass. Powell skating up with it right now, though. Powell deking through the defense. And a great shot, but a nice save by Rice as Powell tried to do it himself there and almost got it to fall.
Great moves there by Powell. He had a scoring opportunity that almost came to fruition for him. The puck was even bouncing over the goalie's head, it looked like, but he was able to bat it away. And great moves by Powell, who's been so strong for the Owls in this game.
And that's going to be an offsides call as Dumbach was trying to take it there himself. And Powell just missed a goal. It hit the shoulder of Rice. And he did a good job right there. You said at the beginning of this period that if he kept up his strong play, maybe he'd make an appearance as a star of the game. And right now it seems like he's trying to do that. And about 15 seconds left on the power play for the Owls. They may have one more rush left in them. Nucero looking for Powell. Devlin gets it. Gets it to Dumbach. Dumbach looking for something. Gets it to Smith. Smith's shot. That goes wide right. And the teams are back at even strength. So Devlin with the puck right now. And Dumbach throwing it into the zone. Westchester now looking for an opportunity as they have successfully killed the power play. Powell now with it after a good play by the Temple defense, and a couple players collide right there. And Bolognese with it right now. A shot from the right of Richards goes over the net. Bolognese back with the puck, trying to get it in front of the net. Nucero, though, able to get it out of the zone, and Westchester will chase. The Owls will switch.
Great job by Westchester killing off the end of that power play opportunity for Temple. Now they're trying to turn in some scoring opportunities of their own. They've got some sustained pressure going so far. Let's see if they can capitalize on it.
And Horacek almost doing himself there. And that shot is stopped by Richards, but unable to hold on to it. And another shot, a deflection, but a good save by Richards. Here comes Murray with it, passing it to a teammate, but that is wide. And the Rams will get it back and look for an opportunity. This is Flick with it. And Giazza skating up with it right now. But he'll turn it over back to Flick. Krulikowski keeping it in. A good job by Flick again to knock it out of the air. A two-on-one almost, but Swartz was able to get the puck. Krulikowski trying to get it to a teammate, unable to, but here comes Wojciechowski. He'll throw it into the zone. 12:44 left in the third period. Owls up 4-2. And a two-on-two opportunity here for the Golden Rams. A shot, good save by Richards. The rebound goes back out in front of the net. Westchester has it back now. And Giazza now looking for a two-on-one with Pierce, but his pass is wide of Pierce's stick. And Westchester able to get back on defense as the Owls switch lines, and they squandered that opportunity on the 2-on-1.
Back and forth action here so far in this period. A great opportunity for Giazza and Pierce. Unfortunately, Pierce was unable to accept the pass in the neutral zone from Giazza, or else they would have had, it, like you said, a 2-on-1 opportunity.
And that shot in through the neutral zone. Richards' glove save, and he stopped it. So 11:56 left here in the game.
We're seeing the shot total for Westchester go up to close to what Temple's used to seeing in a game. They're at 35 shots here, not even halfway through this third period. Temple's, like we said, Temple's using the basic upwards of 50, even last week, almost 70 shots per game. So, you know, hopefully Richards can look strong in the rest of this period, because if I had to put money down, Patrick, I'd say that he is going to be facing a lot of offensive pressure for the final 11 minutes or so of this game.
Well, the Golden Rams, in a little over 8 minutes of play in the period, already have 8 shots. So not something that you want to have your goalie face a shot a minute. But it always could be worse, and Richards is stopping most of the shots he's faced so far today.
Absolutely. We talked about Richards before the game, how he might not necessarily be the stronger start for the Owls, or stronger of the two goalies, excuse me, for the Owls based on how they played so far this season, but he has been no slouch in net tonight, or today, excuse me. He has been playing very well
and
this afternoon.
And a great opportunity for the Owls, but Dumbach's shot goes into the chest of Rice. JD, the play by Richards is nothing to sneeze at here today. Surprised you didn't say that in your last analysis, but someone's got to say it on this broadcast at least once.
I'm trying to switch things up, you know, make our viewers, you know, not know what to expect every time. I want to stay unpredictable.
Want to keep them on their toes.
Absolutely.
Now Westchester looking for an opportunity. Mango with it, but Devlin fighting him. A couple of players coming in to help. Powell comes away with it, but a good play by Horacek to get his skate in front of it. Deflect it back into their offensive zone. Dumbach, with the puck right now. The Owls looking to get it out of their zone. A shot by Flick, and that'll be off Richards. And Richards got collided into right there. That looks like it's going to be a penalty against the Owls, not the Golden Rams there. and that'll be a stoppage of play.
Interesting to see what this call here will be. Looks like a cross-check on the Owls. I'm surprised, Patrick, that the Golden Rams didn't get called for goalie interference. One of their defenders sent Richards down, but it looks like they're saying that that defender was checked, cross-checked in the back into Richards. So now it's going to be a two-minute power play for the Golden Rams. Crucial for the Owls to kill this power play off, more so than any other one in this game. If they can't kill this off, the momentum will go all the way back to Westchester.
And Taylor Smith taking the penalty for the Owls and the cross-check. And now Giazza chasing after it on the penalty kill. The freshman doing a good job right there. Looks like he just shot out of the cannon on that one.
Absolutely.
And Westchester looking for something in the corner. A shot in front. A good job by the defense to just get in the way of that. Looks like Krulikowski now getting the puck out of the zone, but it won't go the length of the ice. And Mango with it right here. Now it's Horacek, the leading point scorer for the Golden Rams, getting to Swole. Sorry, that's Swall. Now Mango with it, looking for someone, but Krulikowski able to get there. He's going to skate with it, looking for something as there's a minute gone on this penalty kill for the Owls. Krulikowski able to get it all the way to there off in the zone, but unable to do anything else with it as Westchester back on the attack. This is Balones, who has one of the two goals for the Golden Rams. Gets it back to a teammate. The defense trying to get in the way of it. 40 seconds now left on the penalty kill. And a good one-time opportunity right there, but Cole was unable to get it onto his stick as a good job there. Devlin clearing at the length of the ice. Still 23 seconds left on the penalty kill.
Great job by the Owls so far killing off this penalty, especially facing such tough lineups. Horacek and Mango, two of the best players for Westchester, were on there, and they've been able to kill this one off so far.
And that's going to be a goal. Look at the flick of his wrist. Number 24, Leo Flick, able to score the goal off the crossbar, beating Richards. 11 seconds left on the penalty for the Owls, and that'll put the Golden Rams within one. And JD, all three of their goals have come on a power play this game.
It looks like I spoke too soon here, Patrick. Just as I said that they were doing a phenomenal job of killing off the penalty, Flick with the gorgeous shot. Richards did everything he could to stop that shot, but unfortunately it went right over his right shoulder and hit the top of the crossbar and bounced in.
So now the Owls only one goal advantage here with a little less than 9 minutes left in the game. And now the Golden Rams with another opportunity, a 3-on-2, the shot, good save by Richards. Murray now with it, he'll throw it out of the zone, but Powell grabs it out of the air. Maybe not the best job by Powell, but the Owls trying to get it out as Richards with another save. Another shot is deflected. That goes out of play. It will have a stoppage.
I mentioned it before. Westchester went on this their most recent power play, Patrick. Momentum is a huge key, especially when killing off that power play. Temple allowed a goal, which has given Westchester all the momentum. And they're coming out here right now, Patrick, and playing like they are down three goals rather than just one goal. They're getting a lot of scoring opportunities, getting a lot of shots. Temple's got to play strong defense for the remaining 8.5 minutes of this game. They want to come out on top.
And JD, in the last 3.5 minutes, the Golden Rams have had 8 shots on net. So we were talking about that early as another opportunity, but a good job there by Ploppert to play defense. But you can't have 8 shots in less than 4 minutes on your goalie. That's not sustainable. And there was a power play in there, but still too many as a great glove save off a Horacek shot. And there's 8:02 left. The Owls still leading by one.
Absolutely, Patrick. You said it best. You can't allow 8 shots in 3 minutes. Now 9 in a little bit over 3 minutes. Richards has been phenomenal on that today. He has had 41 saves on the 44 shots that he's faced. But if you want to stay on top of this game, you got to stop him from getting so many scoring opportunities. He's going to do the best that he can in the rest of this game, but you got to stop them if you want to win this
and
one.
Another great opportunity for Westchester. Shot off the faceoff. Richards got his blocker on it, but just wide left off that blocker save. And now the Owls will try to gain back some momentum as Westchester has really held it in this period, and that's going to go all the way back in the zone as Dumbach can't get his stick on it. So the Owls are going to start something. Pierce able to get his stick on it for the deflection. This is Swall with it. And Westchester again the shot, but a good save by Richards. And Seachuk goes down. But Westchester still with it. Flick looking for it, but can't get his stick on it. Pierce will chase after it. And the Owls look like they're just chasing after everything right now. And a shot right there. Good play by Wushner to get in front of it, but the Westchester Golden Rams will keep possession of it. Looks like they're on a power play right now, but they aren't. The Owls just can't get it out of the zone. Flick now with it. Gets it to a teammate behind the net. He throws it on net with a backhand, but Richard's able to poke that one away. He has it, just able to get it out of the zone.
Owls about to get a line change here, a must-needed line change, because like you said, Patrick, it looked like almost Westchester's on a power play during those opportunities.
And the defense is actually standing out there for the Owls with Dumbach and Seachuk, but the forwards will switch. And that shot right there, that was a screen, but luckily went wide left. And Devlin now trying to get it out. He gets it to Powell. Powell looking for something. He's going to skate it around the faceoff circle. Get it to Devlin. Back to Powell. Devlin. Powell now skating in it. And his shot off of the glove of Rice. As Westchester will have the opportunity. No, Swartz able to get it in the zone. And this is Swall with it right here. The Owls did get a nice line change in there. Westchester with another opportunity. Good play by Swartz to get his skate on it. Smith with it right now, unable to get it out of the zone. Swartz comes to help. Devlin also helping out, but Horacek gets it back, skating in. There are three Temple defenders on him. Krulikowski able to get that out. And that'll be a stoppage right there. It looks like the Golden Rams were celebrating a goal, but I don't think a goal will be called on this one.
I think the ref blew the whistle before the goal, and puck ended up going to the net. The Westchester, like you said, the Westchester players had their hands up. They certainly thought it was a goal, but it looks like it is not going to be a goal going forward in this game. Looks like Richards was able to stop it in time.
And there is 5:14 left in the game. The Owls up one goal. But JD, they were down 24 to 27 shots coming into this period. They are now down 29 to 48, and that is unheard of. They're being outshot 5 to 21 in this period.
Absolutely, Patrick. Westchester has definitely been playing the stronger play this period, as the shot total can count. They're definitely came into this period down two goals, and they've been playing like it this whole period. They're very hungry for a goal right now. Hopefully Temple can stop them from getting one.
And a nice shot, but a good save by Richards. And everyone on the ice looks like they were trying to fight for it right there, but the puck gets stopped, and there's a pile in front of the net as the refs are just trying to peel players off each other.
Definitely a pile up in front of the net there, Patrick. Looks like there's been many scoring opportunities so far here for Westchester, but Richards has really been very sound in this third period. He has let up one goal, but he's faced, like you said, what is it, 22, 23 shots now so far in this period? 24 now in this period, so he is definitely, looks like one of the teams taking a timeout here, and I would assume Westchester, and it looks like Richards has been sound. It's going forward in this game, he's going to have to be their man. Only 4 minutes, 40 seconds left, up a goal. He's going to have to be stout going forward for the rest of this game if they want to keep this lead.
Well, he already has 48 shots, and to be fair to Richards, he has done a lot in the net, gotten a lot of good saves, but there's also been a lot of open opportunities where Westchester just could not bury the puck, so he's going to have to get better on that if they're going to win this game, because all it takes is one wrong bounce for this game to be tied. And on the other end, the Owls offense, really, it might just be the Owls defense, needs to generate the offense, but they have only 5 shots this period, and they haven't been able to keep the puck in the offensive zone, largely because they can't get it out of their defensive zone. And every time they do, it looks like they're just throwing it out to try to get a line change or just try to get the pressure off of Richards.
Absolutely, Patrick. Like I said earlier in the game, Temple's lucky that they are still hit by a goal in this game because Westchester has had many opportunities that have unluckily, bounced one way or the other, so they weren't able to bury the shot. But you know, going forward in this game, Temple's going to have to play some stout defense. I don't think the name of the game right now is creating scoring chances. I think with 4 minutes and 40 seconds left, that's kind of going out the window. I think the strategy here, Patrick, is park the bus. You got to stop the defensive up. You got to stop Westchester from scoring goals and play stout defense for the rest of this game.
Well, JD, we'll hope that the Owls can do that as there's 4.5 left. A good opportunity as Rice has to come out of the net with the puck. The Owls unable to get anything going for it. And Westchester back on the offensive attack. And they've been outplaying the Owls since that power play, really.
This has definitely been Westchester's period so far in here. Temple's got to, you know, keep trying to, it's all about defense now. They got to keep trying to secure this one goal lead so that they can come away victorious.
And an icing called as, JD, it looked like Giazza was actually going to get to that puck first, but the refs called the icing. Maybe we should get Dylan back in here doing play-by-play. Maybe it was good luck for this team.
Yes.
Because they're not playing too hot this period.
Yeah, seriously. I'm just saying, when Dylan was on the call, they scored 2 goals and didn't let up any. When I'm on the call, they let up 1 and didn't score any goals so far. So, you know, maybe bring him back on for some good
maybe
luck.
Maybe you're just bad luck, JD.
It's got to be it.
Wichner will take the faceoff for the Owls. Mango will be in for the Golden Rams. Wichner wins it back to Trevs. But Westchester able to take it right back. This is Mango with it. The shot is wide right. Giazza just throws it out of the zone. The Owls will change, and the Golden Rams will look to get something started. Trevs with a good job right there to get a stick on it, but Westchester still with possession. And this is Horacek with it right now. He's looking for something, sends it up to Cinetti. Westchester passing it around really well right now, looking for the right angle for a shot. Back to Cinetti. Cinetti to Mango. Mango can't keep a stick on it, though. Powell racing over for the Owls, and now there's a couple players together at the boards fighting for it, but Westchester gets it back. Horacek now with it. And he's trying to get it to his teammate. Powell does a good job to get in the way, but Westchester still with possession. Now Powell with it, throws it out, and now it'll be Powell on the breakaway. Powell and Rice, he's got one man to beat, and he shoots it wide right. Powell unable to get the breakaway opportunity to fall, and that puck got stuck on the back of the net, so that'll be a stoppage. 2:51 left here in the period, and the Owls still lead by 1 goal.
Powell visibly disappointed there. He had the hat trick in his sights, but unfortunately he was not able to get the shot on net, and the game remains a 1 goal game. But an offensive zone faceoff here for the Owls. Hopefully they could get it going.
And now Swartz with the puck. A shot from Swartz, but that's wide right. Krulikowski now with it. Krulikowski wrapping it around, trying to get it to Ploppert. Westchester trying to go on the attack. The pass goes off a skate, though. Swartz now with it, throws it into the zone. Rice will take that, leave it for a teammate. Betzker coming in for it. Westchester still with it. 2:23 left in the game. So keep an eye on that net for the Golden Rams as we go forward. Might be pulling their goalie sometime soon. Nucero now with it, gets it out of the zone. Westchester still on the attack. Krulikowski coming up for it. A good job there by Krulikowski as he stands up a defender trying to hit him as well. This is Swall with it, getting it to a teammate who sends it up. 1:55 left, and it looks like Rice is going to the bench. No, he'll stay back as the Golden Rams unable to get it in, and that's going to be an offsides call. 1:47 left. Again, keep an eye on Rice. He was about to go to the bench, but the puck came out of the zone. So 1:47, Owls lead by 1, and the Rams about to pull their goalie. This is Mango and Wojcicki. Mango wins it. That puck goes into the zone. Trev's trying to pick it up. Giazza now fighting for it. Giazza doing a good job getting it out of the zone. Wojcicki coming up for it. It's a 2-on-1. Wojcicki's got Pierce to his right. Wojcicki's shot is wide right of the net.
Temple's had these breakaway opportunities late here in the period, and both times they were not able to put the puck on the net. That's crucial. Even if you don't score, you got to at least put the puck on the net. Should rattle the goalie a little bit.
Wojcicki now with the puck and to Giazza. Giazza almost had a great opportunity 1-on-1, but unable to hang on to the puck as Rice goes to the bench. It is now 6-on-5. A good play by Bolognese, and that shot is deflected. The net comes off its bearings. 1:04 left. The Owls will have a defensive zone faceoff.
Hard to see there if Richards was able to get that save or not. If he was, that was incredible. He dove back to his right. The Westchester player might have missed it or it might have been deflected, but if he was able to get that shot off and Richard made that save, that's one heck of a save there, Patrick.
And now it will be Powell and Mango on the faceoff for each team. Powell needs to win this back, and it goes out of the zone. No, they're able to keep it in. Westchester still with the attack. Again, empty net, so if the Owls can get it out, they will have a great opportunity. Pierce unable to get it out there. Westchester still with the opportunity. Under a minute left here in the game. That shot is going to be deflected wide in the net. And Dumbach now with it. Dumbach trying to get it out of the zone. He's unable to. Powell loses the puck. Westchester still with the opportunity. A shot right there deflected, but wide right. 30 seconds left. Trebs now with it. He gets hit by Flick. Westchester trying to get something on net. Mango trying to get it to Flick. Powell is in on there for the defense. Trebs right now with it, getting swarmed by the Westchester players. And now Powell will come to help out. Giazza, great job, tips it out of the zone. 10 seconds left. The Owls will change. One more opportunity for Westchester. That goes wider than that. 3 seconds left. And the Owls will win this game on Senior Day. 4-3. Hayden Richards ends up with 52 saves. As JD, it got a little bit hairy there at the
Heart's
end of the
pounding.
Game. But the Owls able to hang on for the victory against Westchester.
The win here was sealed by the play from Charles Giazza, as we saw. With about 12 or 15 seconds left in this game, Westchester almost had a scoring opportunity, but Giazza was able to deflect that and end the chance, which was huge for Temple. I don't know what else to say, Patrick. My heart's pounding. We don't usually get to see these close-action games commentating Temple games, especially not one that goes in favor of the Owls. So really great game here, really great play all around. And a fantastic finish by two teams who are playing great hockey.
Well, JD, there's just got to be something about Senior Day. You weren't around for it last season, but the Senior Day against the Drexel Dragons with the playoff spot on the line, the Owls actually won it in very similar fashion to today, and that was to clinch playoffs. So something about this team on Senior Day, they just like playing the close games, and that is a win for the Temple Owls. We haven't said that too much this year. Hayden Richards gets his second win of the season in a well-played game in every facet.
Absolutely. When you mentioned the seniors, you can't mention the seniors today without mentioning the play by Hayden Richards. Incredible play back there for him, especially in the third period. Only allowed one goal on a large volume of shots. I lost count, to be quite honest with you, Patrick, but I know it was above 25, maybe even reached 30 shots. But, like I said, wonderful play all around, but you really got to thank your man in net for the victory in this game.
Yeah, Hayden Richards with 52 saves. That's a good job by any stretch of the imagination. And classic Temple fashion, they do allow 50 shots. There were 28 shots there in that third period, so not what you wanted to see. And after about 8 minutes left in the period, the Owls didn't even generate a shot on net themselves. So just a good job by Richards and the defense holding off as much as they could. And that's a win for the Owls. They will have one more game here at Revolution Ice Gardens before the end of the season. And JD, this was our senior game too. This is one of our last calls here at home.
Where's my rose?
JD, I'll get you a rose.
Okay,
if you
thank you.
Want one. But very good play here from the Owls, and a great note for the seniors to end here for Krulikowski, Richards, Swartz, and Moischner. Very good play by all of them, especially Richards with the 52 saves.
Absolutely. Like you said, out of those four seniors, only one of them being Moischner has not played multiple years here for this Temple program, but all four of them this whole season have been leaders. Krulikowski, even the captain, Richards getting some play in that. All of them have been staples on this team. They're definitely going to be sorely missed.
Well, that'll do it for us. Thank you for tuning in. JD, I always forget this. JD does have to add his three stars in the game. So, JD.
Every time.
Let me have it.
All right. Well, thank you for letting me know. So, it was definitely hard to call, but I think I'm going to give all three of my stars to Temple Owls players. They really played a heck of a game out here today. Third star has to go to the man we've been talking about all season, Ryan Dumbach. He had a goal in this game. I believe he had an assist. But just in every, almost every scoring opportunity you saw for the Owls, he was involved somehow, whether it be keeping the puck in the zone on the blue line and getting a shot or setting up with a great pass. Dumbach today and all season has really been a star, so I really have to give him a third. But the second star, I'm going to give it to Joey Powell. He had two goals in this game and some impressive play, impressive faceoff work. He had that breakaway at the end that unfortunately wasn't able to find Twine, but he was really all over there on the ice, so he's definitely going to have to be second star. And for the first star, I have to give it to the senior in net, Hayden Richards. He let up three goals, like you said, on 55 shots, three goals. That's still 52 saves, especially in the third period. He did let up one goal in the third, but he was a rock there in net, facing a high volume of shots. And there's just not much else you can say about the senior goalie. He came in here, you know, I'll admit that before this game I was a little worried because he hasn't really been seeing a lot of the action recently. It's mostly been on the younger guy, Auerbach. But he came in here, he played a great game, and he was able to help the Owls come away with a win.
All right, so I would have to agree with that, JD. Very strong three stars, very strong players for the Owls, and Richards with a great game today on Senior Day. So on that note, that will be the end of our broadcast. And thank you for tuning in. For JD Fogarty and the rest of our crew, a special thanks to Dylan Coyle for coming in and joining us today. Thank you all for tuning in, and goodbye.